Okay, write the equation of the line passing through the point 6, negative 2, and a slope of negative 2 thirds. Do it by writing the point slope formula. So here we are, we're going to use that point slope formula again. Y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1, and we're plugging in. Remember, this is your x1, and that is your y1. All right, so we have y minus y1 is your negative 2. Don't put 2, put negative 2. That's your slope. Okay, so your slope is negative 2 thirds. And then you must put this in parentheses, x minus your x1 was 6. Okay, so we have y plus 2 equals negative 2 thirds. We're going to do the distributive property, negative 2 thirds x. Now, a negative times a negative is plus 2 thirds times 6. So when you cancel, we're going to get y plus 2 is negative 2 thirds x plus 4, and then just subtract 2 from both sides. Get y equals negative 2 thirds x plus 2. Alright, because it says solve for y to write in slope intercept form. So what's the y-intercept? 0, 2. Now let's make sure that this, we're going to check it. Is 6 negative 2 on this line? That means if I plug that in for x and y, is it true? So you're going to plug in negative 2 for y and 6 for x and see if you get the same thing on both sides. Well, this side is just negative 2, but over here, if we cancel, you get negative 4 plus 2, which is negative 2. So, yep. So this is the right equation. Alright, so here we're going to solve a system of equations by using substitution. So since it says use substitution, it means we want to see if something we could easily solve for one of the variables, and here it is. It's already solved for y. Y is 2x plus 7. So we're going to take the other equation, 2x minus 3y equals negative 13, and we're going to substitute in place of that y, the 2x, plus 7. So we have 2x minus 3, and you better put that in parentheses, 2x plus 7. And now we have a linear equation to solve. So distribute your negative 3, not just 3, so it's negative 6x minus 21 equals negative 13. Negative 4x minus 21 is negative 13. Now we can go ahead and add 21 to both sides. So that'll give us negative 4x equals positive 8. So we're going to divide both sides by negative 4. And we get x as negative 2. All right, so it looks like we've got the solution for x. It's negative 2. Now that we know what x is, we can go back to here, right? So we know y equals 2x plus 7, and now that we know what x is, we're going to plug that in. X is negative 2. So we have negative 4 plus 7 is 3. So now the other coordinate is 3. And you want to make sure by checking in the first equation, actually in both, but especially the first one, is 2 times negative 2 minus 3 times 3, does that really equal negative 13? So I've got negative 4 minus 9 equals negative 13, yes, so looks good. All right, here's another system where we're going to use the addition method. So we need to get either the y's or the x's to cancel out here. So say I'm going to move over a little bit. Here we go. And I really just want to look at either the x values or y values, and I want to see if I can get the least common denominator for the coefficients and opposite signs. So I've got a negative 4 and a 2. The least common denominator is 4. If I multiply the bottom equation by 2, I'll get a plus 4y, and that'll do it. So I'm going to take the bottom equation and multiply it by 2. The top equation I'm going to just keep the same. 5x minus 4y equals 19. And the bottom, don't put an equal. You put this implies sign, double arrow. 6x plus 4y equals 14. Then when I add them up, I have 11x plus 0 equals 33. How convenient. Divide by 11. X is 3. So I've got the x coordinate for my answer. Now we go back to one of the original equations, either one of the original ones, and plug in 3 for x. So I'm going to plug it into this second equation, the 3x plus 2y. That was the original. Don't do it into 6x plus 4y is 14. I'm going to plug in 3 for x. So I have 9 plus 2y is 7. Subtract 9. That means 2y is negative 2, or y is negative 1. So the y value is negative 1. Now we're going to check that in the other equation. All right, so let's check it. You should check it in both, but at least the one you didn't just now work with. Let's see, if I put in 3 for x and negative 1 for y, I have 15 plus 4 is 19. And on the right side, I have 19. So, yeehaw, that is the correct solution. So it's 3, negative 1. Remember, these are ordered pairs. 3, negative 1.